My name is Allie and welcome to my channel. Today I'm going to be doing my November wrap-up and my December TBR. For the month of November, I read 9 books, and one of them was a novella, another one was a poetry collection, and the rest of them were novels, just regular old novels. And also, I forgot, one of them is nonfiction, so there's that. The rest of them are novels. So going in the order of which I read these books, the first one that I read in November was The Diviners by Libba Bray, and I absolutely love this book. I think I gave it a 4 out of 5 stars. I really, really enjoyed it. This is a book that took me actual years to finish. I think I started it in 2015 or 2016, I can't remember. It's either one of those years, and I started it, never finished it. But I got actually really far into it because I was listening to the audiobook, and I just didn't know that I got that far into it, so I bought this at a used book sale, and I decided to kind of read it from like the middle because it's a long story, it's very complicated, so I just tried to start reading it in the middle. And I realized that I actually had gotten really, really far into this book, like even way past the middle the first time I tried to read it. So I don't know why I didn't finish it that first time, but I didn't. And I finally did finish it. I absolutely loved it. I liked it way more reading it as a physical copy rather than listening to it on audiobook. Even though the audiobook is really, really good, it's better for me to read it physically. The next book I read in November was Throne of Glass by Sarah J. Maas. And I read this for the Time Turner Book Club, and I have kind of mixed feelings about this book now. It was a reread for me. I read it like I think last year, and I'm pretty sure I gave it either a 4 out of 5 stars or a 5 out of 5 stars, but this time around I gave it a 3 out of 5 stars. If you want to know more about my thoughts on this book, I have an entire video. It's almost like 30 minutes long, and I just talk about this book, I rant about it, and I will leave a link to that video down below in the description. The next book I read in November was Grace and the Fever by Zan Romanoff, and I gave this book a 4 out of 5 stars. So basically, if you don't know about this book, it follows a girl and she meets one of the most famous and most beloved members of one of her favorite boy bands, and they kind of hit it off, and it's just kind of like a one-off thing, and so the paparazzi end up taking a picture of them together, and it blows up into something way bigger than it initially started off as. And it's basically like if a fan fiction was written really well and was turned into a book. Like, that's the only way I can describe this book, is that it's kind of like fan fiction if it was real life and if it was written really well and in a YA book. I don't know, like, that's just how it is. It's so good. I absolutely loved it. I think I give this one 4 out of 5 stars. There's just some things that I didn't really enjoy, but I mean, it kind of works itself out in the end, so it's okay. But yeah, anyway, enjoyed this book. It was really good. If you want to read my review, I'll leave it linked down below somewhere. The next book I read in November was Legendary by Stephanie Garber, and this is the sequel to Carval, and this follows the main character's sister. And yeah, I gave this book, I think, a 3 out of 5 stars. I didn't like it as much as I liked Carval, and I don't know if that's because I read Carval as an audiobook and then this one as a physical book, or if it's just I just didn't like it. So I expected to really enjoy this book. I had come into this book with really, really high expectations because a lot of people who didn't like Carval that much ended up really loving Legendary. So I think it kind of worked out opposite to me. I really enjoyed Carval, and this one ended up letting me down a little bit, but I am really interested in reading the next book, and I think that finale will be a lot better than Legendary. I'm hoping it will be. I don't know. That's just like my high hopes for the rest of the series. This one didn't have as many twists and turns and like, oh my gosh, surprises as the first one did, so I just didn't end up liking it. So because I was really disappointed with Legendary and I had really enjoyed Grace and the Fever, I decided to pick up Kill the Boy Band by Goldie Moldovsky. I still have a hard time pronouncing her name. So Goldie Moldovsky, I think is how you pronounce it. And I absolutely loved this book. I can't remember if I rated it a 4 out of 5 stars or a 5 out of 5 stars. I think it was 4 out of 5 because there were some like just things that I wasn't super into as well. If you like the movie Heathers, this is 100% the book for you. It is so gritty and so funny and edgy, and it's so well done. And there's a lot of like mystery and twists and turns in this book. And I really liked how you never really know the main character's name. She just keeps going by 80s characters' names. And I thought that was super interesting. And yeah, if you're really into boy bands, or if you really loved like the Jonas Brothers or 5 Seconds of Summer or One Direction or whoever, then you're really going to love this book. And I totally recommend it, either this one or Grace and the Fever. They're pretty different, but they have sort of the same premises. So I feel like, you know, if you're more into like the edgy humor, this book is for you. And then if you're more into kind of like the romance and sort like that kind of book, I feel like Grace and the Fever is more for you, but they're pretty compatible books. So you could read one right after the other. The next book I read is one I read for school, and that is Making the White Man's Indian by Angela Elias. And I rated this book 2 out of 5 stars, and I really didn't enjoy it. I don't want to go too much into it because it is a book for school, but I just didn't feel like it accomplished what I had wanted it to do, which is kind of bad that I'm like projecting my own, you know, wants and needs onto this book, but I feel like I kind of have to because, you know, I wanted it to be more focused and say something interesting or different about this topic of representation, but it didn't really say anything at all. It just kind of worked as a timeline of representation for Native American people rather than using that timeline to make a statement. So I just had a lot of issues with it. I did end up getting a really good grade on my book review, so that was good. And it is my professor's, or one of my professor's favorite books, so I kind of felt bad, but I just didn't like it, and I don't think that it accomplished what it should have accomplished. The next book I read was Evidence of the Affair by Taylor Jenkins Reid, and that is, I think, like a novella, short story sort of thing, but it's actually told in correspondence between these two people, and one of them has found out that her husband is cheating on this other person's wife, or cheating with this other person's wife on her. It's confusing to like explain, but it's really, really good. It's the first Taylor Jenkins Reid thing I've read from start to finish. I have tried to read her book, The 7 Husbands of Evelyn Hugo, but I just didn't like the writing style, and it felt a little too like Hallmark movie or whatever. Like, that's the writing style it just felt like to me. But I actually really ended up enjoying Evidence of the Affair. I really loved the writing style. I felt the characters were really strong, and I was actually really just like, I loved the relationships. I felt really invested in them, and I thought that was super important. So I think I'm gonna try out some of her other books that aren't The 7 Husbands of Evelyn Hugo, because I might actually like her writing. It's just I just didn't like the writing in that particular book. But yeah, so I enjoyed this novella. It was really good. I think I gave it a 4 out of 5 stars. So yeah, definitely one that I would recommend if you're looking for something short to read and you're trying to get like your Goodreads goal or whatever. Another book I read was actually a poetry collection, and that was Semicolon by Michaela Debonis. And I really enjoyed this one as well. I think I gave it a 4 out of 5 stars. I have really, really enjoyed all of her poetry collections that I've read from her. I feel like she has a really direct sense of how she wants her poetry collections to be read as like a very cohesive storyline. I feel like she does that really well. There are some poetry collections that I've read from other people who feel kind of all over the place and they don't really have direction, but hers definitely goes with like a 3-part story progression. It's really, really well done. I feel like she's really good at writing poetry. There are a few poems that I feel like could have been left out or just didn't really impact me in any sort of emotional way. But for the most part, I think she does a really good job, and I absolutely love modern poetry. And yeah, I loved it, and I thought it was really good, and I recommend any of her poetry collections. In the very last book I read in November was Clockwork Angel by Cassandra Clare. And this is the first Cassandra Clare book I have finished in years. I think the last Cassandra Clare book that I finished all the way through was back in my senior year of high school. So I haven't really gotten back to her books in quite a few years. I think it's been like, what, 5 years? So I decided to pick up the entire series for this book, and I absolutely love this first one. I read about like 300 pages of it in one day, and it's just like, I love this. It's so much fun. And this is exactly what I've been looking for. Something that's kind of Victorian, something that's kind of like romantic, but not too romantic, and has some action, but not too much action. It has a good love triangle, and I've been recommended this so many times because everyone knows I love love triangles. So this is kind of one of the best ones that people have recommended me, and I just loved it. And I have the whole series. I'm so excited just to marathon this series. It's so good. And if you want to talk about it with me, feel free to DM me on Twitter because I have so many thoughts, emotions, and feelings. Okay, on to all the books that I plan to read in December. So these are in no particular order. I'm just gonna take them off the stack as they come. And the first one is Lips Touch Three Times by Lainey Taylor with illustrations by Jim DiBartolo. And I have had this book for quite a while. I got it in a library sale once, and it's very, very short. So I'm planning on reading this in maybe one day and just, you know, kind of enjoying some of the stories. I've heard that the stories are really good, and I love this cover, and I've been wanting to read it, and I've never really read anything by Lainey Taylor all the way through. So it'd be really nice to kind of, you know, have this one under my belt. The next one is one I promised to read on Twitter, and that is Empire of Storms by Sarah J. Maas. Yeah, so I've gotten, let's see, I think about 213 pages into this book, and that was at the beginning of this year, and I never ended up finishing it. And I really want to finish this by the end of the year, so next year I can get to Tower of Dawn, I can get to Kingdom of Ash, and I'm really excited about those books. So yes, we're finally going to get to this one. I know it's taken me forever. I feel really bad about it. So yes, we're finally going to finish it. These next two books are part of my marathon read of the Infernal Devices trilogy, and that is Clockwork Prince and Clockwork Princess, both of which I got these all from Thrift Books. Thrift Books is my main homie right now. It's just been so helpful, and I absolutely have fallen in love with Thrift Books. Anyway, I am so excited. I've already started this one last night. I read the first like 7 pages, so I think that was the prologue. And I have this one as well, and I'm just so excited to marathon these two books and get my heart broken and cry and have all the feelings. The next book is the one that I am reading for my book club, We Read the Bard. And if you want to join in with us, we are reading a Shakespeare play once every month. I think one Shakespeare play a month. Did that make any sense? I don't think it did. Anyway, if you want to join, the link to my Twitter account for that book club is down below. And this month in December, we are reading Hamlet by William Shakespeare. And I'm so excited to read this. I have loved Hamlet ever since senior year of high school. It is my ultimate favorite play of Shakespeare's, just out of all of them that I've read. And I'm so excited to get to read this book and talk about it with everyone who's joining in with this book club. And we're gonna have an amazing time. We're just gonna have such a grand old time reading this book. It's just like, I love this. I love it so much. I'm so excited. And the very last book that I want to read in December is because the movie is coming out this month, and that is Dumplin' by Julie Murphy. And I am so excited to read this book because I've had this book for a little while and I've heard so many good things about it. And yeah, the movie looks really good. I've seen the trailer, it looks awesome. And I really want to read this before I get into the movie. I didn't do that with Simon vs. the Homo Sapiens Agenda. I actually watched Love, Simon before reading the book. So I would much rather go into the movie having known what the book is about. All right, so that was my wrap up and my TBR. I hope you enjoyed this video. And if you did, go ahead and give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. And let me know in a comment down below what books you read in November and what books you plan to read in December. And also go follow all of my social media links. They're all linked down below. I hope you have a wonderful rest of your day, and I will see you in my next video. Bye. Thank you.